Hello students, how are you all? I hope you all are doing great. I am Neha Rajvanshi and I welcome you all in our today's class, that is English class of class 9th. So students, we have started reading with our chapter number 2 from the book Beehive. The name of the chapter is The Sound of Music, right? And as we all know that this chapter is written into two different parts, and in the previous video we have completed our part 1, okay? And that part was about Evelyn Glennie, a very famous, a very successful musician, okay? And she was completely deaf, okay? And we have read her journey, the challenges that were there in her life, and you know how she overcame all the challenges, all the difficulties, and finally how she was able to be a successful musician, okay? So her journey is having a lot of, you know, motivation and inspiration for all of us, right? And in today's video we will start reading with our second part of the chapter, okay? So let's begin part 2, okay? So what is the title of part 2? It is The Shehnai of Bismillah Khan, okay? So this part is about Mr. Bismillah Khan, right? So we all have heard his name, Ustad Bismillah Khan, right? In this picture we can see his Ustad Bismillah Khan, a very famous Shehnai player, right? And you know, I am very much sure that most of you must have, you know, you have heard his performance, you have listened him playing the Shehnai, okay? So we will know more about him in this part. So let's begin. Before starting reading the chapter, let's get some idea about the chapter. Think of the Shehnai, and the first thing you will probably imagine is a wedding or a similar occasion or function, okay? So the writer is saying that, you know, if you are thinking about Shehnai, okay, agar Shehnai word aap sunte ho, to ye word sunte hi, the first thing that is there in your mind is a wedding, okay, or a similar occasion or functions, right? So hum sabne bhi dekha hai, हम सबकी फैमिलीज में जब भी कोई वेडिंग होती है, कोई मैरिज होती है, राइट, या और कोई ऑस्पिशियस ओकेजन होता है, ओके, सो टू सेलिब्रेट दोज ओकेजन जनरली शहनाई जो है वो प्ले की जाती है, ओके, सो जैसे ही हम शहनाई वर्ड सुनते हैं, द फर्स्ट थिंग दैट इज देयर इन आवर माइंड इज अ वेडिंग, ओके. The next would probably be Ustad Bismillah Khan, the Shehnai maestro playing this instrument, okay? So first thing that is there in our mind is wedding, okay? And the second thing that is there in our mind is Ustad Bismillah Khan, right? So the Shehnai word hai, right? That is connected with Ustad Bismillah Khan. Why? Because he is the Shehnai maestro, okay? And playing this instrument, okay? And hamare mind mein wo image aa jati hai that how Ustad Bismillah Khan, he used to play Shehnai so melodiously, okay? So we will know more about his life, his journey to be a successful Shehnai player in this chapter, okay? So let's begin. Emperor Aurangzeb banned the playing of a musical instrument called Pungi in the royal residence, for it had a shrill, unpleasant sound, okay? So the writer is saying that, you know, Emperor Aurangzeb, okay? So ye us time ki baat hai jab India pe, you know, Mughal rule hua karta tha, and when there was Aurangzeb, Emperor Aurangzeb, okay? So Aurangzeb ne kya kiya tha? He banned the playing of a musical instrument called Pungi, okay? So there was one musical instrument called Pungi. In this picture we can see this is Pungi, okay? So Aurangzeb, he banned this musical instrument, okay? So what is banned? Banned means to prohibit, okay? So Aurangzeb ne, you know, mana kar diya tha ki ye jo instrument hai Pungi, isko play nahi kiya jayega. Kahan pe? In the royal residence. Why? For it had a shrill, unpleasant sound, okay? So what was the reason that Emperor Aurangzeb, he banned playing of this instrument, that was Pungi? The reason was that Pungi was having a shrill, unpleasant sound, okay? So what is shrill? Shrill means something that is very sharp, okay? So jab bhi Pungi ko play kiya jata tha, so ye bahut hi shrill, unpleasant sound produce kiya karti thi. So this was the reason that Emperor Aurangzeb, he banned, okay? Unhone is instrument ko ban kar diya tha, koi bhi is instrument ko play nahi kar sakta tha, okay? Pungi became the generic name for reeded noise makers, okay? So after that, Pungi, it became the generic name, okay? So what is generic? Generic means relating to a group of things, okay? So it was the representative of reeded noise makers, okay? So here noise maker word jo hai ye refer karta hai musical instruments, okay? And what are reeded instruments? Reeded means wind instruments, okay, which have reeds, okay? So in this picture we वी कैन से दीज ऑल आर रीडेड इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स. ओके, सो इन सभी इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स को रिप्रेजेंट करने के लिए यू नो पुंगी वर्ड्स यूज किया जाने लगा था, और ऐसा माना जाने लगा था कि जो सारे इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स होते हैं ये सभी भी यू नो बहुत ज़्यादा अनप्लेजेंट, बहुत ज़्यादा श्रिल साउंड प्रोड्यूस करते हैं. ओके, Few had thought that it would one day be revived. Okay, अब जब औरंगजेब ने, एम्परर औरंगजेब ने बैन कर दिया था पुंगी को, और पुंगी के साथ साथ सबको ये लगने लगा था कि जितने भी रीडेड इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स होते हैं ऑल आर हैविंग द सेम श्रिल, सेम अनप्लीजेंट साउंड. ओके, सो एट ए टाइम फ्यू पीपल, ओके, सो फ्यू इज अ नेगेटिव वर्ड. ओके, इट मीन्स देर वर यू नो नो वन वॉज देयर हु वॉज हैविंग दिस आइडिया डेट इट वुड वन डे बी रिवाइव्ड. ओके, सो वॉट इज रिवाइव? रिवाइव मीन्स टू ब्रिंग बैक टू लाइफ. ओके, सो किसी को भी ये बिल्कुल भी आइडिया नहीं था कि कोई दिन ऐसा वापस आएगा जब ये जो सारे इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स हैं राइट, इन सबको फिर से यूज़ किया जाएगा, इन सबको फिर से इंजॉय किया जाएगा, सब इसकी जो साउंड है उसे इंजॉय करेंगे. ओके, सबको लग रहा था कि अभी जो रीडेड इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स हैं ये हमेशा के लिए यू नो बैन हो चुके हैं, फिर से कभी भी ये इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स प्ले नहीं किए जाएंगे. ओके, अ बार्बर ऑफ अ फैमिली ऑफ प्रोफेशनल म्यूजिशियंस हु हैड एक्सेस टू द रॉयल पैलेस डिसाइडेड टू इम्प्रूव द टोनल क्वालिटी ऑफ द पुंगी. ओके, सो एट दैट टाइम देर वॉज वन बार्बर. ओके, एंड दैट बार्बर वॉज ऑफ अ फैमिली ऑफ प्रोफेशनल म्यूजिशियंस राइट, एंड ही वॉज हैविंग द एक्सेस टू द रॉयल पैलेस. ओके, सो वॉट इज एक्सेस? एक्सेस मीन्स ही वॉज एबल टू गो टू द रॉयल पैलेस. ओके, एंड ही डिसाइडेड टू इम्प्रूव द टोनल क्वालिटी ऑफ द पुंगी. ओके, सो व्हाट इज टोनल? टोनल मींस अ साउंड. ओके, सो पुंगी को बैन क्यों किया गया था? बिकॉज ये बहुत ही शार्प, बहुत ही श्रिल, बहुत ही अनप्लीजेंट साउंड प्रोड्यूस करती थी. ओके, सो दिस बार्बर ही डिसाइडेड दैट ही विल इंप्रूव द साउंड क्वालिटी ऑफ पुंगी. वो इस तरह से इंप्रूवमेंट करेगा कि जब पुंगी को प्ले किया जाएगा सो जो साउंड होगी वो अनप्लीजेंट ना हो, वो प्लीजेंट साउंड हो, मेलोडियस साउंड हो. ओके, सो ही डिसाइडेड टू इंप्रूव द टोनल क्वालिटी, और वी कैन से द साउंड क्वालिटी ऑफ पुंगी राइट. ही चोज अ पाइप विथ अ नेचुरल होलो स्टेम डैट वॉज लॉन्गर एंड ब्रॉडर देन द पुंगी एंड मेड 7 होल्स ऑन द बॉडी ऑफ द पाइप. ओके, एंड टू इम्प्रूव द साउंड क्वालिटी ऑफ द पुंगी वॉट डिड ही डू? फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल ही चोज अ पाइप. ओके, एंड डैट पाइप वॉज हैविंग अ नेचुरल होलो स्टेम. ओके, विथ एंड इट पाइप वॉज लॉन्गर एंड ब्रॉडर देन द पुंगी. ओके, सो जो पुंगी हुआ करती थी उसकी जो शेप होती थी राइट, उससे ज़्यादा लॉन्गर, उससे ज़्यादा ब्रॉडर पाइप उन्होंने लिया उस बाबर ने, एंड देन ही मेड 7 होल्स. ओके, ऑन द बॉडी ऑफ द पाइप. ओके, सो एक्चुअली ही वॉज इन्वेंटिंग, ही वॉज डिस्कवरिंग अ न्यू म्यूजिकल इंस्ट्रूमेंट राइट, बिकॉज पुंगी को उन्होंने यू नो थोड़ा सा चेंज करने का आइडिया उनके माइंड में आया कि थोड़ा सा चेंज करके यू नो उसको इस तरह का बना दें कि जब इसको प्ले किया जाए तो ये बहुत ही प्लेजेंट, बहुत ही मेलोडियस साउंड क्रिएट करे. ओके, सो फॉर दैट पर्पज ही चोज अ पाइप and that was you know longer and broader than pungi, and on that pipe he made 7 holes. Okay, when he played on it closing and opening some of these holes soft and melodious sounds were produced. Okay, and finally when that musical instrument was ready and when he played on it. Okay, is tarah ke instruments hum kaise play karte hain? By closing and opening some of these holes. Okay, so usme 7 holes the, usko play karne ke liye uske alag alag tune yani kaise create karte hain, kabhi hum koi se hole ko band karte hain, kabhi kuch holes ko hum open karte hain right, like you know for example I can say you know flute hum sabne देखी है. ओके, सो फ्लूट भी हम इसी तरह से प्ले करते हैं, उसमें भी यू नो होल्स होते हैं और अलग अलग ट्यून हम क्रिएट करते हैं, उसके होल्स को हम क्लोज करते हैं और कभी होल्स को हम ओपन करते हैं. ओके, सो दिस बार्बर व्हेन ही वाज फाइनली विद दिस न्यू इंस्ट्रूमेंट देन ही वाज प्लेइंग दिस इंस्ट्रूमेंट बाय क्लोजिंग एंड ओपनिंग सम ऑफ द होल्स. ओके, देन व्हाट हैपेंड? सॉफ्ट एंड मेलोडियस साउंड्स वर प्रोड्यूस्ड. ओके, सो नाउ ये जो नया इंस्ट्रूमेंट था, व्हेन द बार्बर ही वाज प्लेइंग दिस इंस्ट्रूमेंट देन यू नो वेरी सॉफ्ट एंड मेलोडियस sounds were produced by this new musical instrument. Okay, he played the instrument before royalty and everyone was impressed. Okay, and now this barber, when he was well prepared with this new instrument, then he played the instrument before royalty. Royalty means jo royal people the, jo palace ke people the right, jo emperor the aur jo baki unki family ke royal members the, so before royalty he played that new instrument and now everyone was so impressed. Why? Because that instrument was having very soft, very melodious, very pleasant sound. Okay, The instrument so different from the pungi had to be given a new name. Okay, so now it was a new instrument and it was so different from pungi. Okay, वो pungi जैसा नहीं लग रहा था. उसकी जो shape थी right, वो pungi से बहुत ज़्यादा different थी because it was larger, it was broader than pungi. Okay, and it was a new musical instrument. So obviously it had to be given a new name. Okay, so उस instrument को pungi नहीं कह सकते थे because उसकी जो sound थी right, sound quality भी pungi से बहुत डिफरेंट थी. ओके, और उसकी जो शेप थी डेट वॉज ऑल्सो क्वाइट डिफरेंट फ्रॉम पुंगी. ओके, सो ऑब्वियसली डेट न्यू म्यूजिकल इंस्ट्रूमेंट नीडेड टू हैव अ न्यू नेम. ओके, As the story goes, since it was first played in the Shah's chamber and was played by a Nai or we can say Barber, the instrument was named the Shehnai. Okay, so ab us instrument ko ek new name dena tha. So uska new name kaise rakha gaya? So there is one story about this, and as the story goes, since it was first played in the Shah's chamber, okay, so us instrument ka naam kya rakha gaya tha? Shehnai. Okay, it was named the Shehnai. Aur ye jo word hai Shehnai, ये कहां से आया था? Because it was first played in the Shah's chamber. Okay, so first of all, उस instrument को कहां play किया गया था? In the Shah's chamber, and it was played by a Nai. Okay, so Babar को हम क्या कहते हैं हिंदी लैंग्वेज में? Nai, right? So it was played by a Nai, and first of all, this musical instrument was played in the Shah's chamber. Okay, तो शाह है Nai. Okay, इन दोनों words को आपस में you know merge कर दिया गया था, और इस तरह से क्या नाम produce हुआ था? Shehnai. Okay, and that was the reason the instrument was named as Shehnai, right? And in this picture we can see this is the musical instrument, that is Shehnai, right? So this is the story. ki jo instrument hai Shehnai, right, isko kis tarah se invent kiya gaya tha, kisne kiya tha, this is the story. Okay, so when Aurangzeb he banned the playing of pungi, right, then one barber was there and he invented this different musical instrument that was having very soft, very melodious sound. Okay, and this instrument was named as Shehnai. Clear? The sound of the Shehnai began to be considered auspicious. Okay, अब ये म्यूजिकल इंस्ट्रूमेंट जो था Shehnai, right, इसकी जो साउंड थी डेट वॉज सो सॉफ्ट, डेट वॉज सो मेलोडियस, डेट यू नो एवरी वन वॉज यू नो स्टार्टेड लाइकिंग दिस म्यूजिकल इंस्ट्रूमेंट. ओके, और इस इंस्ट्रूमेंट को बहुत कॉमनली यू नो प्ले किया जाने लगा था, और जनरली कहाँ प्ले होता था ये जो इसकी जो साउंड थी राइट, डैट साउंड वॉज कंसिडर्ड टू बी वेरी ऑस्पिशियस. ओके, सो वॉट इज ऑस्पिशियस? ऑस्पिशियस means something that is promising to bring good fortune, right? So iski jo sound thi, that sound was considered to be very auspicious. Okay, and for this reason it is still played in temples and is indispensable component of any North Indian wedding. Okay, so this is instrument Shehnai, it is regarded to be very auspicious, and this is the reason that still till date this instrument is played in temples, right? Abhi bhi hum dekh sakte hain jo bhi बहुत ही फेमस टेम्पल्स है राइट, उन टेम्पल्स में अभी भी शहनाई प्ले की जाती है, एंड इट इज़ एन इंडिस्पेंसिबल कॉम्पोनेंट ऑफ एनी नॉर्थ इंडियन वेडिंग. ओके, और स्पेशली नॉर्थ इंडिया में शहनाई जो है डेट इज़ क्वाइट पॉपुलर. सो नॉर्थ इंडिया की जो भी वेडिंग होती है, ओके, सो इन ऑल दोज वेडिंग शहनाई इज़ एन इंडिस्पेंसिबल कॉम्पोनेंट. ओके, सो वॉट इज इंडिस्पेंसिबल? इट इज़ नेसेसरी. ओके, एंड कॉम्पोनेंट इज अ पार्ट. ओके, सो शहनाई इज़ अ वेरी नेसेसरी पार्ट ऑफ ऑल the North Indian weddings. Okay, so generally जो शहनाई है that is played in temples and in weddings, especially North Indian weddings. Why? Because इसकी जो sound है that is considered to be very auspicious. Okay, in the past the Shehnai was part of the nobat or traditional ensemble of 9 instruments found at royal courts. Okay, so agar hum past ki baat kare jab isko invent kiya hi gaya tha, so after that ye jo instrument hai Shehnai, it was the part of a nobat. Okay, so there was one term known as nobat, aur ye nobat kya tha? It was there were 9 instrument. Okay, so ek group tha 9 instruments ka. Ensemble means we can say things considered as a group. Okay, so 9 different musical instruments ka ek group tha, that group was known as nobat. Okay, so jo shehnai thi that was also a part of this group known as nobat. Okay, aur ye jo group tha ye kahan pe play karta tha music? In the royal courts. Okay, so starting mein jo shehnai thi wo specially temples mein weddings pe play ki jati thi, and it was also a part of this group known as nobat. Okay, टिल रिसेंटली इट वॉज यूज ओनली इन टेम्पल्स एंड वेडिंग्स. ओके, और अभी तक जो शहनाई थी डैट वॉज यूज ओनली इन टेम्पल्स एंड वेडिंग्स, राइट. उसको बहुत ज़्यादा ऐसे जनरली म्यूजिकल इवेंट्स में, किसी कॉन्सर्ट्स में यूज़ नहीं किया जाता था. डैट वॉज प्लेड ओनली इन वेडिंग्स और वी कैन से ओनली इन टेम्पल्स. ओके, द क्रेडिट फॉर ब्रिंगिंग दिस इंस्ट्रूमेंट ऑन टू द क्लासिकल स्टेज गोज टू उस्ताद बिस्मिल्ला खान, राइट. सो अब तक जो ये इंस्ट्रूमेंट है शहनाई, ओके, वो इतना कॉमनली यूज़ नहीं होता था. डैट वॉज प्लेड ओनली वी कैन से इन टेम्पल्स और ओनली ऑन द ओकेजन्स ऑफ वेडिंग और एनी अदर फंक्शन. बट द क्रेडिट फॉर ब्रिंगिंग दिस इंस्ट्रूमेंट ऑन टू द क्लासिकल स्टेज गोज टू हुम, उस्ताद बिस्मिल्ला खान, राइट. सो ही वॉज द पर्सन, ही वॉज अ पर्सनैलिटी हु इज हैविंग द क्रेडिट टू ब्रिंग दिस इंस्ट्रूमेंट ऑन टू द क्लासिकल स्टेज. ओके, एज अ 5-year-old बिस्मिल्ला खां प्लेट गिल्ली डंडा नियर अ पॉन्ड इन द एंशियंट एस्टेट ऑफ दुमराव इन बिहार. ओके, सो नाउ लेट्स रीड समथिंग अबाउट दिस ग्रेट पर्सनैलिटी उस्ताद बिस्मिल्ला खान. सो वैन ही वॉज अ 5-year-old चाइल्ड, ओके, सो एट दैट टाइम एज अ चाइल्ड बिस्मिल्ला खान ही यूज टू प्ले गिल्ली डंडा. ओके, सो गिल्ली डंडा इज अ वेरी कॉमन गेम स्पेशली इन रूरल एरियाज. ओके, इन दिस पिक्चर वी कैन से दिस इज द गेम डैट इज गुल्ली डंडा. ओके, सो उस्ताद बिस्मिल्ला खान वैन ही वॉज अ स्मॉल किड ऑफ 5-year-old, सो एट अ टाइम ही ऑल्सो यूज टू प्ले दिस गेम डैट इज गिल्ली डंडा एंड वेयर नियर अ पॉन्ड इन द एंशियंट एस्टेट ऑफ दुमराव इन बिहार. ओके, सो अपने चाइल्डहुड में कहाँ रहा करते थे, ही यूज टू स्टे बिहार और वहाँ पे एक यू नो एक स्टेट था डैट वॉज दुमराव. ओके, सो वेयर ही यूज टू प्ले दिस गेम गिल्ली डंडा, राइट. He would regularly go to the nearby Bihariji temple to sing the Bhojpuri Chaita, at the end of which he would earn a big laddu weighing 1.25 kg, a prize given by the local Maharaja. Okay, so at that time when he was a 5-year-old kid, so at that time he would regularly go to the nearby Bihariji temple. Okay, so there was one very famous temple that is Bihariji temple, so there he used to go. Why? To sing the Bhojpuri Chaita. Okay, so this is a very famous song, very famous local song of Bihar that is in Bhojpuri language. Okay, and at the end of which he would earn a big laddu, okay, as a reward. And aur jo laddu ka jo weight hota tha wo kitna hota tha, it was almost 1.25 kg. okay, and it was like a reward, it was like a prize that was given by the local Maharaja. Okay, so us estate ke jo Maharaja hua hote the, okay, he used to give वन लड्डू टू बिस्मिल्ला खान. ओके, जब वो ये परफॉर्मेंस दिया करते थे भोजपुरी चैता की, सो आफ्टर दैट द महाराजा ही यूज टू गिव हिम अ लड्डू. ओके, और उस लड्डू का वेट होता था ऑलमोस्ट 1.25 kg. ओके, इट वॉज लाइक अ रिवॉर्ड, इट वॉज लाइक अ प्राइज फॉर हिम. ओके, This happened 80 years ago and the little boy has travelled far to earn the highest civilian award in India, that is the Bharat Ratna. Okay, so when he was just a 5-year-old kid, okay, so at that time as a prize he used to receive a laddu. Okay, but that small girl, jo child the, wo jo small child the, okay, he travelled so far to earn the highest civilian award. Okay, and what is the highest civilian award in India? It is the Bharat Ratna. Okay, and this happened 80 years ago. Okay, यानी कि जो भारत रत्न उनको दिया गया था उससे almost 80 years पहले तक तो क्या होता था, as a reward he used to get a laddu. Okay, but after 80 years that small child was able to go such a beyond. Okay, that he was able to get the highest civilian award in India, that is the Bharat Ratna. Okay, so this is the journey of that small child, okay, who used to play gilli danda, who used to sing a local song in a local language, okay, and who used to receive a laddu as a prize. Okay, but the same child, he goes, you know, wo unhone itna far travel kiya tha, itne famous ho gaye the as a shehnai player, that finally he was able to receive the highest civilian award in India. Okay, born on 21st March 1916, Bismilla belongs to a well-known family of musicians from Bihar, okay. So, now Ustad Bismilla Khan, he was born on 21st March 1916, okay. And he belongs to a well-known family of musicians from Bihar, okay. So, as we have read earlier, that you know, unka jo childhood tha, wo Bihar mein hua tha. So, he was born in Bihar only, okay. His grandfather, Rasool Baksh Khan, was the Shehnai Nawaz of the Bhojpur King's Court, okay. And what was the name of his grandfather? Ustad Bismillah Khan's grandfather was Mr. Rasool Baksh Khan, okay. And he was the Shehnai Nawaz of the Bhojpur King's Court, right. His father, Paigambar Baksh, and other paternal ancestors were also great Shehnai players, okay. And what was the name of his father? His father is Paigambar Baksh, okay. And some other paternal ancestors also, they used to play Shehnai, okay. And what is paternal ancestor? Paternal ancestors means jo father ki family ke ancestors hote hain, okay. So unke jo grandfather the, inke jo father the, aur bhi jo baki ancestors the, okay, they all were great Shehnai players, okay. So music was in his blood, we can say, okay, because unke jo ancestors the, his father, his grandfather and many other paternal ancestors, they were great Shehnai players. So we can say that, you know, he inherited music, or we can say especially the art how to play Shehnai from his family, okay, from his father, from his grandfather and from other paternal ancestors, okay. So we will know more about this great personality in the next video. So see you in the next video. Thank you.